Students, here you have been asked to prove that the time period for sine nx and cos nx, where n is a positive integer, is 2 pi by n. Let f of x is equal to sine nx, which can be written as the function is going to repeat it for every 2 pi radians. So it will be written as sine of nx plus 2 pi. So when you take n outside of the bracket, it will become sine of n into x plus 2 pi by n. So this can be written as f of x plus 2 pi by n. And it is of the form f of x is equal to f of x plus t. So the time period of sine nx can be taken as 2 pi by n. Similarly, let f of x is equal to cos nx, and this cos nx function, the variation is going to repeat it for every 2 pi radians, and cos nx can be equated to cos of nx plus 2 pi. From this, taking n outside the bracket, it will become cos of n into x plus 2 pi by n. And look into the equation, this is equal to cos of x plus t type. Therefore, f of x is equal to cos of, therefore f of x is equal to f of x plus 2 pi by n. Therefore, the time period of cos nx will be taken as 2 pi by n. Now, let us discuss the limit of a function. You look into the graph given in this slide. For the variation of x, for each and every value of x in the function f of x, you will be getting a value of y. And we have given four values of x, we are getting four values of y. They are marked, and the variation is marked as a graph here. And at a, y is becoming, at x is equal to a, y is becoming l. And there have been marked a delta to the left hand side of a, and there has been marked a delta to the right hand side of a also. So a minus delta, we are getting a point. And for a plus delta, we are getting a point. And the gap between f of a and f of a minus delta, the corresponding gap in the y value is epsilon. For a value between f of a minus delta and f of a, we are getting a difference of value from L. It is L minus epsilon. Similarly, for a gap of value between f of a and f of a plus delta, we are getting, for f of a we are getting L, and for f of a plus delta we are getting another point, and there is a difference between L. It is L minus epsilon is equal to L minus L plus epsilon. So you have to look into the picture clearly. Now we shall go for defining the limit of a function. A function is f of x is said to tend to a limit L as x tends to a. This you can easily understand from the picture. When x is equal to a, the function tends to the value of L. A function f of x is said to tend to a limit L as x tends to a, if to each given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a positive number delta such that f of x minus modulus of f of x minus L will be less than epsilon. When x is less than x minus a, modulus of x minus a, which is less than delta. This step you need to understand very clearly. We are comparing the variation in the y-axis to the variation of the given values in the x-axis. And this is denoted by limit of x tends to a, f of x is equal to L. Once again, the definition is repeated. A function f of x is said to tend to a value, said to tend to a limit L as x tends to a, if to each given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a positive number delta such that modulus of f of x minus L will be less than delta when 0 is less than modulus of x minus a is less than delta. These conditions are to be satisfied. The condition at the y-axis and the condition at the x-axis are to be satisfied. Then only the limit of a function will be denoted by limit of x tends to a, f of x is equal to L. Limit of a function, it is explained in other words also, whenever a point x is within delta units of a, then f of x is within units of L. This also you have to keep in mind. If x into delta is given to, if x is given a value units, then f of x will be within L into epsilon units, L into epsilon. So this you need to understand. So limit of a function is defined in two ways. These definitions are to be kept in mind, and you, if you look into the picture, you will clearly understand. So the limit of a function is compared with the variation of the substitution of the values for x in the x-axis to the variation of the values of y obtained on the y-axis. So there have been given two conditions. Those two conditions at the x-axis and on the y-axis are to be kept in mind. If these two conditions are satisfied, then the limit of the function f of x where x tends to a will be equal to L. So this is the explanation for the limit of a function.